Hi, we are AGH Space Systems, a team from AGH University of Krakow, Poland. For this year's European Rover Challenge, we're thrilled to once again present our rover, Kalman. Kalman is a continuously evolving project that we've been maintaining for over 8 years now. Its highly modular design has allowed us to keep updating it over time, making sure it continues performing as best as possible under changing conditions and requirements. Our team is made up of students with expertise in fields ranging from robotics and computer science to chemistry and geology. We work in 5 specialized subteams: mechanics, electronics, software, science, and documentation support. Each subteam elects its own leader who is responsible for overseeing the progress and coordinating with the rest of the team. We believe that our participation in the European Rover Challenge adds value to an event that truly inspires the academic community. For that same reason, each year we engage with schools and exhibit at science fairs to spark curiosity in future generations. Moreover, ERC motivates us to continuously collaborate on the development of our project. We strive to share the knowledge we've gained with other teams and raise the bar collectively, pushing both ourselves and the Rover Challenge community towards greater innovation. To give you a closer look at the thought process, challenges and solutions behind our design, let's hear directly from the engineers who make it all happen.
The suspension is based on a rocker design. It was manufactured with aluminium alloys, 3D printed PETG parts and polyamide 6 with molybdenum disulfide elements. Finite element analysis was used to engineer its lightweight structure, which is strong enough to bear even the toughest loads. The propulsion system features 4 independently turning wheels, which allow the rover to rotate in place and drive forward, sideways or diagonally. There's an easily reachable emergency stop button, which physically breaks the connection to the batteries, completely shutting off the motors.
We 3D print our LS tires with a gyroid lattice infield that dampens vibrations and provides shock absorption. In order to design their structure, we ran many simulations and performed empirical testing. We focused on optimizing the mechanical design to increase ground clearance and stability on uneven terrain.
Kalman's chassis is a welded aluminum frame designed with mass production as a priority. The chassis has extension slots for mounting rods at every corner, which are designed to carry mission-specific equipment, such as cameras, status LEDs, communication transceivers, and many more.
Our power delivery system uses 6S lithium-ion batteries that are hot swappable. They slide in and out of 3D printed mountings outside the rover. Each battery is equipped with a custom BMS to ensure safety and provide easy access to diagnostic data. We've developed a custom power distribution board that uses XT standard connectors for all onboard electronics. Each device has a dedicated breaker which prevents potential damage to the batteries.
All the essential PCBs are designed with uniform physical dimensions, sliding seamlessly into a single backlink cage. We call the system Mini Rack. Its modular design enables quick and efficient loadout changes, allowing us to switch between maintenance and navigation missions in under 10 minutes. A remote communication is managed using half-duplex RF modules. Video is provided by several analog cameras and a high-quality digital camera mounted on the arm. Our testing has demonstrated reliable control over the rover at distances reaching 1 km, with minimum video latency.
Our control software runs on a laptop in the ground station. This is a web-based application that provides operators with real-time telemetry and a command interface. Multiple input devices, including gamepads, a space mouse, and a custom wheel controller, provide intuitive control over both the rover and its manipulator. The autonomous localization system uses a dual EKF configuration. We use one filter to merge local odometry readings and another one to fuse global corrections. Local filter takes visual odometry data from 4 dev cameras and rotation changes from the IMU. Global filter uses detected fiducial markers to provide world reference positioning.
The depth cameras aren't only used for localization. They output point clouds that Kalman uses to detect obstacles by analyzing the slope of the terrain. Those obstacles are then accounted for by NAVTOOL, which controls the rover. The framework is configured to use our custom path follower plugin that takes advantage of Kalman's holonomic locomotion capabilities. We've developed a custom robotic simulation in Unity Engine where we can achieve higher fidelity. Powerful C# scripting capabilities are used to implement interactive testing environments. We perform real-world testing on a weekly basis and months leading up to the competition. Such regime ensures that our system will work under the expected conditions.
For the droning subtask, we have prepared a UAV that is capable of autonomous takeoff and landing. The drone can be switched to manual mode at any time using an off-the-shelf ELRS ERC link. This allows the operator to override autonomous commands and, if necessary, initiate an automatic landing. In critical scenarios, we can trigger a full failsafe, which immediately shuts down all the motors. Another onboard safety feature is a geofence, which keeps the drone within mission perimeter. Powered by a custom-made lithium battery pack, the drone boasts 14-inch carbon props and a 650mm frame, which allows it to sustain continuous flight for over 20 minutes. It has a GNSS receiver, optical flow sensor, and a LiDAR for localization. Currently, we are developing a gimbal stabilizer for the camera and an RTK system to improve GNSS accuracy.
The autonomous calculations are performed off-board on a station computer running a MATLAB application. HD video is streamed directly to the computer, which processes the footage to locate probes and the landing spot. Once the coordinates are identified, they are transmitted to the drone via the ELRS connection.
The robotic manipulator has 6 degrees of freedom, which enables us to collect samples, lift objects to great heights, and to execute complex maintenance procedures. The use of wave gears ensures smooth movement between target positions. The arm is designed with modularity in mind. Hence, we are able to easily swap end effector clothes for mission-specific variants. Additional tooling or cameras can be attached on demand, and the whole arm can be dismounted from the chassis.
Each joint is powered by a PMSM motor with a custom control module. The modules are connected together using a CAN FD bus, forming a fault-tolerant distributed system. The main control unit of the arm is a Raspberry Pi CM4 mounted in the mini rack.
The end effector of the arm is controlled using a space mouse, where inverse kinematics are used to steer individual joints. The operator can also initiate an automatic return to one of many predefined poses.
In order to extract subsurface samples, we've been developing a drill module. After manufacturing a prototype, we conducted extensive testing to identify its issues. Then, by consulting with industry experts, we iterated on our design to develop a refined version that addressed all our concerns. The new drill features an improved extraction mechanism with reduced dimensions, and it weighs much less than its predecessor.
The pH measurement unit is integrated on board the rover and will be lowered down from its body in order to investigate samples at the ground level. We can measure on a full pH scale from 0 to 14, and the sensitivity of our instrument is 0.1 pH. Surface samples will be collected using the robotic arm, which will pick up pieces of rock and soil and place them on board in a dedicated sample container. A built-in scale will provide real-time readings to determine the weight of individual samples as well as the total mass of the collected material.
Every subsystem of our rover is a reflection of the dedication and hard work of each and every one of our members. Together, we're creating a truly remarkable machine. But building it is only part of the process. In order to guarantee reliability, we keep on thoroughly testing all components of the rover under relevant conditions. In addition to that, we perform regular simulations of the challenge tasks, which allows our operators to perfect their skills well before the finals. None of this would be possible without support from our university, private sponsors, and the Ministry of Science and Higher Education. Thank you for this incredible opportunity, and as always, see you in space!